If we consider L as our system, then there are two forces. One is the tension force upwards due to spring, and the second one is the gravitational force, that is downwards. Now if these two forces are not aligned, then there will be torque and rotation will be there, and therefore there will not be any rotational equilibrium. For rotational equilibrium, the two forces, tension force and the gravitational force, should be in the same line. Now this is only possible if the center of mass of the L system is aligned with this tension. So center of mass is here, so these two, tension and mg, are in the same line. In that case we can have rotational equilibrium. For center of mass discussion, the situation is very easy. For L rod, let's say this length is L and this length is L, this mass is m, this mass is also m. So to find the x coordinate of the center of mass, we have the formula m into L by 2, because for this m, center is here at L by 2, plus for this mass m into 0 divided by 2m, and that is L by 4, that means here. Likewise, for this direction, it will be L by 4 from here. So L by 4, center of mass is here at L by 4, comma L by 4. Now this center of mass should be aligned with this tension. So now we have this situation, that this is L. Whose center of mass is here, this is L rod, this is L by, this is L, this is L, this is L by 4, this is L by 4. Now string is like this, so this M and this tension, they are in the same line. So if this length is L, this length is L, this is actually, this is L by 4 and this is L by 4. So this is L by 4 and this is also L by 4 here. Right? L by 4, L by 4. L by 4, L by 4. So this length will be 3L by 4. And this is L by 4, so this is also L by 4. And we have 10 theta equal to L by 4. Divided by 3L by 4 or 1 by 3. So the correct answer is 1 by 3.